God speaking to David. And here's what he said.
And when thy days be fulfilled.
When thy days be fulfilled.
And thou shalt sleep with thy father.
Thou shalt sleep with your fathers.
I will set up. Thy seed after thee. Which shall proceed out of thy bowels. And I will establish his kingdom. Yes.
Yeah, go on, read.
He shall build a house.
Now, just that verse.
Yes, sir.
12 and 13 answers all of my questions. But for the sake of brevity and the sake of understanding and cognitive realization, I'm going to move on so I can answer all these things. Now, watch this. He said, when your days are fulfilled and you shall sleep with your father. What does that mean? That means God is saying to David, David, when your seed establish this house, this temple, you are going to be dead.
That's it.
All right, now if you're writing anything down, that's the first mark of the right church. Number one, of the establishment of the right church. Number one, David will be dead. Yeah. Any church established before David died? Wrong church. Established too early. God said David would be dead. And then he said that you won't do it, David, but your seed will.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, your seed going to do it. And who is that seed? The seed there is Jesus Christ himself. All right, now, so we have the first qualification of the right one, and that is, you will know it. You will know it when you see it. And the way you're going to know it when you see it, you're going to be able to ask a few historical questions. Number one, is David the prophet dead? That's the first biblical mark of it. David the prophet is dead. You see? And Christ is the seed. Yeah, he's the seed. And he's the one that's going to establish his church. But I think I better read Hebrews chapter 3 before I go any further. Hebrews chapter number 3 and verse number 6. I think I may need to read that because that's important. Hebrews chapter 3 and verse number 6. Brother
but Powell, Christ.
But Christ.
As a son.
Over his own house.
Whose house.
Are we. Now Christ has a house. Christ has a church. God has a house. And one thing about this business, the Bible said the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. God owns everything. But he doesn't have but one house. I want to say that again because y'all, I think y'all may have missed that. And that is that God owns everything. But he doesn't have but one house. Yes, sir. And I'm laboring here laboriously trying to get you to see that you can identify this house. You can identify it. Now, get me the seventh chapter of the book of Zechariah. The seventh chapter of the book of Zechariah. And let me see. Let's take a look at verse number 12 of Zechariah, chapter number 7, if you will, Brother Sam. And let's see what the Bible has to say. What does the book say? Zechariah chapter 7. Well, let's try chapter number 6. Zechariah chapter 6 and verse number 12, if you will. And let's see, what does the Bible say? Read.
And speak unto him.
And say what?
And speak unto him. Saying.
Saying what?
Thus speaketh the Lord of hosts.
Yeah.
Saying
what?
Behold the man.
The man.
Whose name.
Is the branch. Now the branch, that's Jesus Christ.
Yes it is.
All right, go on, read.
And he shall grow up. Out of his place. And he shall build the temple of the Lord.
Read.
Even he
shall build the temple of the Lord.
Shall build the temple of the Lord.
And he shall bear the glory.
And he shall bear the glory.
And shall sit.
And shall
sit.
Sit.
And rule.
And rule
upon his throne.
Now the Bible says that Jesus Christ, whose name is the bread, he's going to establish the kingdom, but at the time he's going to be sitting and ruling.
Yeah.
I want to say that again.
Yeah.
He is going to sit and he's going to rule in his kingdom.
Uh-huh.
He is not going to rule until he sits.
Uh-huh.
And when he sits, he's going to rule.
Uh-huh.
So if the question is, when did Jesus start ruling? All you got to find out when he starts sitting. Because when he sat, he began to rule. Now then, we got two marks in here, if you're following me. We got two marks. Number one, David is going to be dead. Number two, Jesus is going to be sitting and he's going to be ruling. All right, well, we're narrowing this thing down here. And not only that, but then the third thing you need to look for is it's going to happen in the last days. Isaiah chapter 2 and verse number 2. The Bible says what?
And it shall come to
pass. And it shall come to pass.
In the last days.
In the last day. When it's going to come to pass, it's going to come to pass in the last day.
Yes, sir.
It's going to, and that's quite a bit I can say about this, but I'm moving. I must move quickly. The Bible says it, and what's the next word after it, Sam?
Shall.
It's going to happen.
Yeah.
Because it's guaranteed.
Yes, sir.
It is guaranteed by the shallness of God. I said it's guaranteed by the shallness of God. Sam, read verse 1, verse 2. Verse 2 says what?
And it shall.
We're talking about the shallness of God. And it shall
come to pass
in the last days
that the mountain of the Lord's house
shall be established
in the top of the mountain and shall be exalted above the hills.
Read.
and all nations
shall go and read some more here. We ain't gonna do that yet.
And many people shall go and say
come ye
and let us go
up to the mountain of the Lord
to the house of the God of Jacob and he will teach us his ways
and we will walk in his path
for out of Zion
shall go forth the Lord
and the word of the Lord
from Jerusalem.
But that ain't all them shall,
but I'm going to stop right there. It is guaranteed by the shallness of God, and if God says it, it's going to come to pass. As it's going to come to pass. Now then, here's what you got. If you're following, number one, when this church, when this house, when this temple, when this kingdom, God's kingdom is going to be established on earth. Number one, David's going to be dead.
Yeah, yeah.
Number two, Jesus Christ is going to be sitting on the throne. And then the number four, that it is going to be in the last days.
Uh-huh.
It's going to be in the last days.
Yes,
so you can't miss it even if you want to miss it.
Yes, sir.
Because the marks are too clear. Now get me Zechariah chapter 1 and verse number 16. That's the when. Now let's do this deal with the where. Zechariah chapter 1 and verse 16. The Bible says what?
Therefore.
Watch this. Therefore.
Thus saith the Lord. I am returned unto Jerusalem. With mercies.
Watch this. I am returned unto Jerusalem with mercy.
My house shall be built.
In it.
Yes, sir.
So where's this place going to be built? It's going to be built in the city of Jerusalem. It's not going to be built in Rome, Italy. It's not going to be built in New York City. It's not going to be built in Kansas City. It's going to be built in Jerusalem. And so watch the marks. Now you can't miss this to save your life. Because when I get through with this, all you have to do is go through a process of deduction. Praise the name of Jesus. That's all you got to do. Just go through a process of deduction. Number one, was David dead when my church was built? Was Christ sitting on the throne when my church was built?